Then you can't know. And I don't know about you, but church and community, I have a problem with that. That bothers me. Too many of our young people are losing their lives. Our young men are losing their lives to guns and violence. Too many of our sons and daughters are losing their lives because of guns and violence. And if you wait on me to get in my message, I'm already in it right now. Because somebody has to say something. Somebody has to lift up a standard. And somebody has to deal with what's going on in the community. And if the church don't want to deal with it, then who's going to deal with the thing? We can't leave it up to the government. This is our community, amen. And what happens in the community affects us, amen. It affects our children. It affects our loved ones. It affects our schools, amen. It affects our church, amen. So we have to be the ones to say, Pastor, we're going to seek God for an answer. We're going to pray to God that God will send us an answer, that God will show us what to do. Because when you put guns in the hands of young people who don't yet know the value of life, then here's what you have, is senseless murders. That's what happens. They're too young to understand the value of life. Matter of fact, you really don't understand the value of life until you get late in the mid-30s and 40s. Amen. All of those who are in their 30s and 40s can understand and know what I'm talking about. And if you live for a while, amen, you learn to appreciate life. And you learn to value the life you have and the life of your loved ones. So whenever somebody gets sick in your family, that's why it concerns you. So because you understand the value of life. So whenever somebody is lost in your family, it grieves you because you understand the value of life.